Professor, we can say that your work consisted in exploring the unexplored, seeking for combinations of biochemical compounds that might exist but are not out there yet. How do you find the right protein or the right enzyme in a world of infinite possibilities?
Ah, that's the good question. That's how evolution works, because there are an infinite number of possibilities for assembling the components of living systems. But evolution has created those that serve life. I can't create the ones that serve life, but I can use evolution to create the ones that serve human beings.
And so we can say in a way that you tamed evolution in the laboratory. And I want to ask you, is it this kind of evolution, directed evolution, predictable in some sense, given some condition? Is it possible to expect certain results?
So I tamed evolution in the sense that humans have tamed evolution for the last thousands of years, making dogs and racehorses and corn. We've been modifying the biological world to create things that serve our purposes. In the sense that we envision something that's useful, that's better than what we have today, it's a reliable process. But you can't always get what you want.
And in this world of infinite possibilities might be hidden some of the solutions for humanity's hardest problems. What kind of solutions have we found so far thanks to your methods?
Well, maybe not the solutions to all the hardest problems, but we're working on that. Enzymes are the best chemists on the planet. They're better than anything a human being can do. And nature uses renewable resources and recycles them into whole new compounds. So the sorts of things that we can find are chemical solutions to making fuels, pharmaceuticals, materials, all the things that we need in our daily lives. Maybe nature could learn how to make those for us.
And do you think that technological and computational developments might help us finding those solutions more quickly, let's say?
The problem with evolution is it's experimentally costly. You have to do a lot of experiments, and it's just like breeding a farm animal. Many of the progeny don't solve the problem. To reduce the number of experiments that we have to do, new computational methods are proving to be extremely useful. So maybe we can jump four generations in a single experimental step. And I see a future where machine learning will combine with experiments to move forward very quickly and efficiently.
And what about new kinds of computations that we see in the horizon, such as quantum computing?
Ah, well, that's still a little ways off for my kind of work. I hope that we will be successful in developing quantum computing methods, and then the future is wide open.
Thank you very much, Professor.
Thank you.